So next up, we're going to do a stretch for the side of the neck. For this exercise, you need a chair or a stool, something that you can wrap your fingers underneath. So I'm gonna take a seat on my stool. Hands go palms facing down onto the lap, just to start with, and we'll take a breath in. Now as you exhale, drop the left ear towards the left shoulder. We're just looking to make sure that there's no tension or compression or pain anywhere before we add the next layer in. So I'm feeling okay here. I'm going to come back out. I'm going to take my right hand and fingers now and wrap them around the bottom of the chair. So this helps to pull my shoulder blade down, and it's going to help to get into the muscles or the tissues here in between my right shoulder and my right neck. So we'll take a breath in. Exhale, drop the left ear towards the left shoulder just until you start to feel tension. Now we're looking for a pain-free edge here. You should be able to soften with your exhale. Just breathe into the tension line when you inhale. If you want to explore stretching some of the different tissues on the front and the back side of the neck, then you can take your chin and drop it forward towards your collarbone. And this should help to stretch out the tissue more on the back side of the neck. And we need to do the opposite to stretch into the tissues on the front side of the neck. So that means lifting the chin up nice and slowly. And as we lift the chin up, the head, the back of the head, of course, is going to tip back behind us. Maybe you'll need to rotate your head towards the left, so chin moving towards the left shoulder just a little bit. And you can play with lifting the chin up and then dropping it back down towards the collarbone. Just moving back and forth between lifting the chin up towards the ceiling, maybe looking over that left shoulder a little bit more, and then dropping the chin back down towards the collarbone. Keeping the chin tucked now, moving through center until your chin ends up right above your breastplate or your sternum. And then from there, we'll lift the head back up and we can switch sides. So remember, we're just gonna do a nice easy check-in to start here by taking the hands, placing them, palms facing down onto the thighs, breath in to start. Exhale, drop your right ear over top of your right shoulder. We're just checking in to make sure that it feels okay to move to the next part of the exercise, so there's no pinching or pain, compression here. So I can come back out and add on the next layer. Take the left hand and fingers, wrap them underneath the bottom of your chair. So we're just depressing the scapula or the shoulder blade here to increase the stretch that we will feel between the neck and the left shoulder. Take a breath in. Exhale, drop your right ear over top of your right shoulder. Just going until you feel that little bit of tension on the left side of the neck. And we're gonna hold and breathe here. And to explore some of the different tissues on the front and back side of the neck, we can of course drop the chin forward and down towards the collarbone here. And then we need to do the opposite to get into the muscles on the front of the neck. So I'm going to lift the chin and tip the head back just until I start to feel a stretch more on the front. Maybe you'll need to take your chin and look over your right shoulder a little bit more. Just play with tipping the head back and rotating the head further, and then dropping the chin back down towards the collarbone. We can rock back and forth, lifting the chin up adding more rotation to the right, and then coming back down, chin towards the collarbone, keeping the chin tucked now as we move through center. So just tracing the collarbone until we arrive right above the breastplate. From there, you can lift your head and neck back up to center. Take both hands, place them on your thighs with palms facing down. And just notice how your neck is feeling.